Hello, and welcome back to our development course. We're going to continue with the HTML section, and in this lecture, we're going to look at HTML headings and paragraphs. So let's get started. HTML headings are defined with the H1 up to H6. So you know the meaning of tags at this level. So if I just say H1 tag up to H6, you understand what I mean. H1 defines the most important heading, and H6 defines the least important heading. You should note that browsers automatically add some white space, bracket margin, before and after a heading. Headings are important. The search engines like Google, Yahoo Search, MSN Search, they use these headings to index the structure of the content in our web browser, in our web pages. So headings are that important. And you should note that we should use the HTML headings for headings only, not to use the HTML headings because you want your text to look big. The different ways we can format our text to look big, but not use HTML headings when you just need your text to look big or bold, because HTML headings are most important. Use it only when it is a certain heading in your web page. We come to horizontal rule. Horizontal rule, we can abbreviate it as HR tag, or we call it HR tag. It defines the thematic break in an HTML page and is the most often displayed as horizontal rule. You're going to look at this when you're going to practice what is meant by horizontal rule. Then horizontal rule element is used to separate content or define in a content defined in an HTML page. That's the meaning of the horizontal rule, just used to separate two different contents in a HTML page. So let us go to our code block, let us go to our Sublime text and practice this horizontal rule and HTML headings. So I'll switch to Sublime text and create a new file. I hope everyone can create a new file at this level. If you cannot, then please go to the previous lectures and understand how to create a new file. So I'll begin by saving, and I will save this as 7_headings. Then press enter. Oh, I forgot to save the extension, so I have to rename this. I'll come here and say servers. Okay, save as. I forgot to put the extension. Save as headings.html. HTML. Then it has been saved. So to write the HTML structure, I'll just write the word HTML and press the tab key, and then press enter. Maybe I'll put here headings. Okay. So after, we say that headings range from H1 up to H2. So I can put H1, I press the tab key. Then it will automatically make my first heading. This is say, I can say this is a biggest heading. Okay, so if I just come and say maybe H3, and this is medium, and then I come and say H1, and this is H6 is the smallest, okay? This is the smallest heading. I hope you're also practicing this. So I'll save, I'll right click in the space and say open my browser. Then it will automatically open in my browser, and you can see the title, this title, headings, is appearing here in a window, the name of the window. Then you can see H1, this one, H1, is the first heading. Then the medium is the H3. Then the H6 is the smallest heading. So you should always know that headings of HTML range from heading 1 up to H6. whereby the most important and the most largest is the H1, H is the least as goes, and then H6 is the most smallest heading or the most least important heading that we may have. Then we also discussed about HR. HR is called the horizontal rule. If you want to separate two contents or different contents in the web page, you use the HR. And remember, it's just an empty tag. You write HR like this, then I press the tab key. Then I save, I come and refresh. You can see it has separated this content from this content. So that's the use of HR. So if I come and paste these ones here down again, you can refresh. You can see this HR, the one that separates the top content from the bottom content. You can use it as many times as you want when you need to separate different contents in your what? In your web page. So I believe you now understand what is meant by headings. Head 1, H2, H3 up to H6. So we proceed with our slides. We shall look at HTML paragraphs. HTML paragraphs, we use a P tag to create a HTML paragraph. Then, a P tag, for example, if we open a P tag here and we close it here, what will be between it, we shall call it HTML paragraph. And browsers automatically add some white space or margin before and after the HTML paragraph. So, let us go to HTML pre-tags. These pre-tags, they are used to define the formatted text. For example, if you have already formatted the text, then we don't need, we use pre-tags, the HTML, to take it exactly the way it is. The text inside a pre-tag element is displayed with a fixed width font, usually Korea font, and it is preserved both space and the breaks. It does not tamper with the format that we have used. You're going to practice this, you're going to see how it means. Then let's switch to the code and see what is meant by pre-tags. First of all, I'll create here my paragraph. Okay, to simply create a paragraph in this Sublime Text, we use the random words called lorem. Just type the word LOREM, lorem, then press the tab key. You'll see some random words will be set for you. If you did not get these random words, please just put your problem in the comment section, then I'll show you how to solve it. You just type the word LOREM, lorem, then press the tab key to show you the random ones. So we're going to create a paragraph B and put the tab key, then press enter and put here some lorem, okay? Then press the tab key. It will bring you the lorem, okay? I'll save it. I'll come here and refresh, okay? I can just say open your browser. So this is our content, and this is our paragraph, as you can see. The paragraph, the last one is the paragraph. Okay, I'll try to grab this, okay, so that you can see properly. So on top we have some headings, below we have a paragraph. Now, even if I press enter here, for example, I press enter 3 times, what to expect? You should expect a new line. But if I come and refresh, we see this space has just been ignored. It has no meaning. HTML ignores that space. But if you need to this space to be considered, is when you use a pre-tag. For example, you have formatted the text, you want HTML to take it exactly the way it is, then we use pre-tag. You just simply type the word pre and press the tab key. Then here you put whatever space that you'll put to be considered. For example, I'll say this, I'll just put maybe my paragraph P and say this is pre-tag. Pre-tag text. Then I can press even enter like 3 times and say it is fine. Okay? So if we don't have pre-tags, these white spaces will be ignored. But with pre-tags, let's see what happens. It takes exactly how we typed our content, and that's how it has looked in the browser. And it has used the Korea font to represent this pre-tag information, the pre-tag. But if we remove the pre-tag, let me remove it. I'll save, come and refresh. All the white space will be ignored. The white space has been ignored. But if you include the pre-tags and save, come and refresh, the white space has been considered. Everything that you format here will be considered. Okay? So that's the meaning of pre-tag. So I hope you've got the meaning. If you did not get the meaning of pre-tag, then put your problem in the comment section and we shall discuss about it. So let us go back to our slides. So here are some HTML tags with their reference. The HTML defines the root of HTML document. The body defines the document's body. The head defines the container for all the HTML elements. For example, the title, script, styles, all of them, we put them in this head tag between these. And this body is the one that will contain the content that we need to display. Then this HTML is the one that contains all the HTML content. In other words, here we tell that our HTML begins here and here it ends. So we go back. H1 up to H6 define the HTML headings. Then HR defines the thematic change in the content, or it breaks the content in the HTML body. And then the BR is the one that inserts a line between, or it breaks a line. Then the pre-tags, it defines the pre-formatted text. It assumes that what you're writing there is already formatted, so it doesn't need to change anything. That's the meaning of pre-tags. So let's meet in the next lecture, whereby we're going to look at the HTML styles. It's going to be interesting, and I hope you'll not miss. Then don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and share this video, and don't forget to like if it was helpful to you. So let's meet in the next lecture. We're going to look at the HTML styles. And thank you for watching.